Hello all. So now we are moving to the isometric view of a circle. So we have to draw the isometric view of a circle of diameter 60 mm, which is placed on the ground or parallel to HP, and the second one it is parallel to VP. So well, we know that the first step is we have to obtain the orthographic projection of the circle and inscribe that circle into a rectangle, right? So that we can draw the circle. And then we can inscribe the circle in the rectangle, right? So as we have done earlier, the method is divide the circle into 8 equal parts, so that we have obtained 8 different points. So now we can draw the corresponding rectangle. It will be a square for that isometric view. It will be a square so that we can obtain the C80 point. One point will be here, one point will be here, 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 and we can obtain the four inside point also like this, so that we can draw the circle like this. It will be an ellipse. This is the actual method for doing this. But in actual practice, there is another better and easier method for constructing the isometric view of a circle. The method is, the first thing is, draw the quadrilateral, draw the rectangle. This is one, since it is placed on the ground, it will be 30 degree 30 degree. Now we can take this distance, locate 2, take those distance, locate 4. So through 2 and through 4, draw the line so that we can obtain the point 3. So that now we have completed the quadrilateral, the rectangle, isometric view of the rectangle where the circle is inscribed. Okay. Now, how can we complete the isometric view of that circle? The method is, see, we can see 4 angles here, right? 2 acute angles and 2 obtuse angles. So select those 2 obtuse angles. Select this angle, select this corner. This is obtuse angle. So it have opposite, 2 sides are there opposite to this angle. Locate the midpoint of this side. Locate the midpoint of this side. Connect with this corner. Connect with this corner. Now, this is another obtuse angle. This is its opposite side's midpoint. Connect like this. Okay. I hope you understood. This is obtuse angle. This is opposite side's midpoint. This is opposite side's midpoint. Connect. This is another obtuse angle. Opposite side's midpoint. Opposite side's midpoint. Keeping this as center and this much portion as radius, draw an arc. Keeping this as center, this much portion as radius, draw another arc. Keeping this as center, this much portion as radius, draw an arc. Keeping this as center, this much portion as radius, draw an arc. This is the isometric view of the circle when it is parallel to HP. Actually, this is the method of constructing an ellipse, which is known as a four-center method. Four-center method. So, this is obtuse angle. Select the opposite side's midpoint. Connect. Keeping this as center, this as radius, draw an arc. Keeping this as center, this as radius, draw an arc. This as center, this as radius, draw an arc. This as center, this as radius, draw an arc. So now we have obtained the isometric when it is parallel to HP. Okay, now we are moving to parallel to VP. So this is one. Since it is a parallel to VP, it is XZ plane. So this is our 30 degree line. Locate 2. We can draw here. This is one. 30 degree. Locate 2. take this distance so that we have obtained 4 through that draw a line parallel to this one, through 2 parallel to this one, so that you have obtained 3. So quadrilateral has been obtained. It can be seen that these two are the two obtuse angles, these two are the two acute angles. So from that obtuse angle, locate the midpoint of this side, locate the midpoint of this side, connect. Locate the midpoint of this side, locate the midpoint of this side, from this point, connect. So this is center 1, this is center 2, this is center 3, this is center 4. That's why it is known as the 4 center method actually. So keeping this as center, this much as radius, draw first arc. Keeping this as center, this much as radius, first arc. This as center, this as radius, draw an arc. This as center, this as radius, so this is the method of constructing isometric view of a circular lamina. So I think all of you have understood this system. Thank you. So we have completed the construction of isometrics of a lamina. In the next video onwards, we are going to the isometrics of prisms. Okay, thank you.